Assalamu alaikum. This is Majid Mahmoud recording for the Merciful Servant YouTube channel. A question, an answer, and an action item which will inshallah have an absolutely amazing effect on your life. Please note that whatever hadith I'm about to mention is authentic inshallah, and you'll find the references of it in the description box under this video. Why would Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with all the knowledge and the wisdom which he had, with all the revelation which he received from Allah, why would he say about the greatest night of the whole year, that night which is more valuable than 1,000 months, 83 years and 4 months, a night that had you donate $1 on, is actually more valuable than donating $30,000 on any other regular night. A night in which the book of guidance, the food of our soul, was revealed. The night in which peace and blessings and tranquility and mercy descends along with the angels to the sama' al-dunya, to the first heaven. The night in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends in a way that befits His majesty after one third of that night. And He says, Ana al-malik, Ana al-malik, I am the king, I am the king. Who here has any dua that I may accept? Who here has any need that I may fulfill? Who here needs my forgiveness so I can forgive? All that greatness continues until the Fajr time, until dawn. Allahu Akbar. Why would the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and don't forget sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why would he say and answer Aisha radiallahu anha's question when she asked him, if I witness that amazing night, ma ad'u, what shall I make dua for? He said, make dua that Allah, make dua Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Oh Allah, basically three statements, total of 7 words. Oh Allah, you are afu. You love to have afu, so please have afu upon me. That's all what he said. I'm sure you would agree with me that this entire amazing great night, for the Prophet to say this short sentence, this sentence and dua must have an amazing value. And absolutely, you're correct. But there's a secret to that dua that the Prophet ﷺ did not say, Allahumma innaka ghafurun tuhibbul maghfira faghfir li. Rather, he used Allah's name, Al-Afu. And for us to appreciate that name and understand that dua more and more, let's look into the meaning of Al-Afu. And let's go actually understand it more and more, compare it with maghfira. So let's look at maghfira, which is forgiveness. If I translate both words, Afu and maghfira, they will come like forgive and pardon. So I'll use the Arabic terms. Maghfira means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had He forgive you with a maghfira part, He will conceal your shortcomings in the dunya, He will not expose you in the akhirah, and He will not punish you for that which you have done. But Allah will confront you with the sins that you've made and will only remind you of it. The believer will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, and Allah will put a curtain between the billions of people and between Allah and that believer. And Allah will tell that person, أَتَعْرِفُ ذَنْبَ كَذَا? Do you recall that sin which you have made? أَتَعْرِفُ ذَنْبَ كَذَا? Do you recall that sin which you have made? And Allah will keep mentioning sins and sins that which the believer have made. Then the believer says, Na'am ay Rabb, yes, O Allah, O my Lord, I do remember. And that believer thinks that they are destroyed, halak. Then Allah says, Satartuha alayka fi dunya wa ana aghfiruha laka al-yawm. I have concealed these sins in the dunya and today I forgive you for it. But brothers and sisters, wouldn't it be so embarrassing to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all of these sins, even though at the end of it you're forgiven? Wouldn't it be embarrassing to come to Allah that said that you watched this, you drank this, you cursed this and that, even though it's forgiven? Wallahi, you would feel so embarrassed had someone look in your history, had perhaps you have a bad history, for example. Had someone see what you've done, even though you've changed, you'll be so embarrassed, like, no, I've changed. But it's so embarrassing, you would wish no one remembers it. Isn't that right? Had you have an atom weight of haya, Isn't that correct, brothers and sisters? You don't want people to remember it, and you only mention it for the sake of benefit to the people. Al-Afu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The linguistic meaning of it, there's two parts of it. Al-Afu means al-mahu wal-izala, erase and wipe away. And it also means another meaning which comes in the verse in the Quran, which I will say for later. Al-mahu wal-izala means wipe and completely erase. So the Arab would say, عَفَتَ الرِّيَاحُ الْآثَارُ. The wind have wiped away, afu, the traces. So you can't tell if someone did actually walk on this path or not. The other meaning that many people perhaps don't know, Al-Afu means al-kathra wa ziyada, excess and abundance. Where did you get that meaning from? When Allah said in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ, and they ask you, what shall they give? Tell them, قُلِ الْعَفُ, tell them to give that which is excess and beyond which they need. Allahu Akbar. Now technically with the dua, put them together. When you go to Allah al-Afu, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu anni. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who loves to have afu, he will erase all of your sins and he will not leave any single trace, and you won't even remember that you've done these sins, and you won't even recall them, and you won't be nervous and you won't be embarrassed because you've not done anything wrong to begin with, and Allah will not remind you of it, and Allah will not punish you of it. And not just that, and Allah will give you everything which you asked for, and will give you much more than what you asked for, that which is good for you. Allahu Akbar. Look at this amazing dua. Shouldn't we go and run to Allah and say that dua from the bottom of our hearts? May Allah make us witness that great night. Say Ameen Ya Rabbal Ameen. May Allah make me and you witness that great night. Oh, you who is complaining that you can't stop backbiting, lying and gossiping. Oh, you who is complaining I can't pray Fajr on time. Oh, sister who's complaining I can't wear the proper hijab. Oh, brother and sister who's complaining I can't respect my parents the way they're supposed to be respected. Those who are complaining, every time I say Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater than everything and anything, I said that but my mind is somewhere else. Know that the thing that is holding you, a simple answer, are your sins. A man came to Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu an. He told him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I used to wake up at night and pray, and for some reason I stopped. I don't know what's the reason. Ali bin Abi Talib said radiallahu an, Innaka rajul qad, Allahu Akbar, you are a man who was qayyadatka dhunubuk, you have been chained by your sins. Brothers and sisters, break these chains, break them out. This is the opportunity. Use every night of the last 10 nights. Laylatul Qadr is one of them. Please don't focus only on the 27th. Be like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to prepare for all of the last 10 nights. He used to do three things. He used to prepare himself physically. He would like roll up his sleeve. أشد مئزرة وأحيا ليلة وأيقظ أهله. He would stay all night praying dua and Quran and dhikr, wake up his family, no sleeping, no games, no videos, no funny videos, nothing, dua and asking Allah al-afu. Brothers and sisters, don't procrastinate. Maybe this is the moment, wallahi, you're looking for to go to the next level, to change your life upside down. Yes, a change overnight, yes, yes, I'm aware of what I'm saying. This is a dua that Allah has gifted us. Wallahi, there's a story that I would love to share with all of you. A sister, a true story that I'm not making up, I heard it from a sheikh myself. A sister who was invited, who was not practicing, wearing very tight jeans, clothing that Allah is not really pleased with. She went and was invited by a practicing sister to attain and hear, sorry, a halaqa that is very similar to what that which we just mentioned. And then when she heard that, she was very touched. May Allah make me and everyone that are hearing these ahadith touched. Ameen Rabbal Alameen. She heard that, and then at the end she said, this is it. From tonight I'm going to wear the proper clothing, that which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sisters were excited. They said, let's go buy you one, and let's come walk with us before you go home. She said, no, I'm not taking a single step outside this masjid until I'm wearing it. Allahu Akbar. No more procrastination. So they saw how she was insisting. They were very happy. Brought her the abaya, gave it to her. She wore it, and then she was walking outside the masjid. As she was crossing the street, a car was driving, hit the sister. She died on the spot. The point of the story is not about hijab. It's about don't procrastinate. Bismillah. Roll up your sleeve. Like Rasul how he prepared himself physically. He would do all what it takes. Sleep in perhaps in the morning that so I can energize you at night. I ask you by Allah, if you can, share that video. Press like if you wish, but what's more important is share. Share so others can benefit. You might be a reason why someone's life would change. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.